It's the pre-election battle that's turned into an ugly and untruthful smear campaign. From claims of nude photo shoots to inaccuracies about her weight, independent candidate Zali Steggall, who's up against Tony Abbott, has been faced with a barrage of online abuse. She's vying for the seat of Warringah and she joins us now. Zali, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Let's just clarify this. Your Wikipedia page has been altered and you've been described as a men's magazine model who appeared nude for a pear industry campaign and also appeared wearing lingerie in a men's magazine as a former sportswoman. It's sexist, it's inaccurate. What can you do about it?
Oh, look, Wikipedia, at least you can get them to change it and lock down the page, so that's fine. But it's more what it means and what kind of leadership are you inspiring if your followers think that that's a way to win an election. I think what it says is actually, and I think someone like Mr. Abbott should be calling it out and really saying that that kind of behaviour is unacceptable. It's that fear and smear, people are tired of it and it's time to move on.
Who's behind it?
Well, again, it's, trolls are always anonymous. You know, I assume it's not people that have represented their country at the Olympics and done great things.
What's your suspicion?
Oh, look, there's no doubt about it that it's from an opponent's point of view. So, again, I wouldn't want to point fingers at who it is, but we know Advance Australia are running ads where they're openly lying about my campaign platform, my position on policies. The reality is I'm just giving Warringah a choice to move on to a more positive future. And it's a real question of what kind of example do you want to set when you're in a position of public service? What kind of people do you want to follow you?
So, just to clarify, Advance Australia is an activist group. It's the conservative alternative to Get Up, and it has you very much in its sights. We know that. It also has a $400,000 election war chest. How do you combat that?
Well, I will be campaigning and I will be moving for changes to the Electoral Commission laws when it comes, when I'm in Parliament, to introduce a minimum standard of truth in political advertising. It's absolutely amazing that there is no requirement for political advertising to actually be fact-based or truthful. It can be anything. And that's what they're doing. So, look, it's disappointing, but I think the electorate are educated and have had enough of that type of behaviour. They want positive policy, they want a positive future, and that's the opportunity I'm giving them to move on.
You, of course, have been accused of being aligned with Get Up, are you?
No, not at all.
In no shape or form?
No shape or form.
No donations, no favours?
No donations, no favours. They are an organisation that raise issues. They do what they then look at candidates and how those candidates match up to their issues. The reality is Get Up came to Warringah in mid-2018 because Mr. Abbott is a climate change denier. That's the truth.
They do accuse you of having policy positions that are closely aligned to Bill Shorten, though.
Well, again, I don't quite understand where that comes from, because climate change is not a left or right position. Climate change is everybody's issue, and I think a lot of moderates like me feel very disenfranchised when it comes to this idea that if you want climate change policy, you somehow must be a lefty.
Just finally and quickly, with all this influence that these lobby groups seem to have, can you understand that the average voter is finding it increasingly difficult to really get a grip and an understanding of what a candidate stands for?
Of course, and I think that's why you have the rise of strong independents, especially independent female candidates, because the public has had enough of the hidden agenda within the parties, of sort of what the power plays and the personal ambitions, and they actually want representatives that are there to represent the people of their electorate.
Any regrets about getting into politics?
No, I'm loving it, and I really can't wait to actually serve the people of Warringah.
All right, well, we will be watching your campaign very closely.
Thanks.